A guy laid this on me when it was legit. He got a thing for the income tax, your internal revenue. So that's the thing, they want to get up some bread. So I said, give me the letter, you're finished with it? Yeah. So what I did was, which you won't be able to see, under their writing, I laid some typewritten matter. I added to it, too. And then the hole here, which I'll put in my friend's name, whoever it is, and photostat it. Because I know, like, if any one of you gets a letter that says, U.S. Treasury Department, Internal Revenue, oh, you don't even open the letter, man. It's no fun, you know. It can't be, no, there's no fantasy of, we're giving you a lot of money back. No, it's serious. Internal Revenue, I open it up, okay, now it says, you are requested to confer with me for the purpose shown below at the time and place indicated. Please present this letter at the time of your appearance and bring any documents or any other information. They really make it very amorphous, right? Very general. Any other documents, anything. In other words, really letting you wide open. Whatever else you stole from us. Yeah, because it really... And any other information which you... But take this wording they use. Which you may believe may be of assistance. Which you may believe, right? Ha, yeah, if you think you can get away with it. Anything else that you need, like a tank you can bring down here, or a dopey, raggedy mother going, flying kids with sores on their legs, anything. Anything you want to bring down, Jim, because we got a file and a big pencil, disallow, disallow, disallow. Yeah, we got a lot of time, and you hear all those wives' tales, yeah, man, they'll spend $1 million getting a penny back. Oh, God, you heard that all your life, man. Don't really spend thousands of dollars just getting a nickel, okay? You better just shut up. What'll I do? I'll go down here and I'll just be cool. No, I'll bring a lawyer. No, if they bring a lawyer, they'll know you're crooked. Okay, well, I don't know what to do. What did you do? I don't know what I did, but I must have been bad, because I'm always bad. Yeah, that's right. That's why when a cop pulls you over, when that red light hits you, the most legit citizen goes, bleh. Yeah. Do you know what you did? No. Yeah, but when a cop pulls you, any one of you, cop... And you always have Walter Mitty fantasies, and I'll say this when I come in. You just get fumbled. Do you know what you did? And they throw real trick things. You made an illegal left, right, and snurpy out of the lane, and you go, all right. Yeah, they just throw words at you. Okay, I made a legal left, and he just sign here. Okay. I know, yeah, we know him too. Just shut up and stuff paper down. So that's kind of a scene. Okay. Now dig what I added to the thing. Okay. Please present this assistance in resolving this matter. If circumstances make it impossible for you to keep this appointment, please advise me promptly and then into my ship. Please advise me promptly. After all, we're human beings like everybody else. A buck is a buck. At least you could have had the human decency to send up something, a dollar, whatever it is, instead of making an asshole of me in front of the whole department. Very truly yours, revenue officer. What is that? P.S. You guys always cry in the blues. You ain't got. Meanwhile, that Nafka wife of yours is going to Miami every year, and that schmucky half-wit son is driving around a Lincoln. What is that? That's a real personal get it up. Yeah, now dig what a laugh this brings. First, it brings a laugh of, oh, it's fake, oh, God. It's really, yeah, I'm not going to jail, you know. Then the other aspect of it, I really like it, because that's a beautiful cliche of a first-generation American trying to be literate, you know. You could have the human decency, you know. Why don't you be a civilized, decent human being? Yeah, they really learn, but they script the idiom. What do you want me to do, get down on my feet and kiss my knees and get up on my heels? They just throw it in, right? Yeah, you don't even have to talk about it. Yeah. Here's like a real Bronx mock trying to be literate, right? Yeah. They find words like, boy, you're terrific. Terrific was a very chic word. Boy, you got a terrific personality on you. Boy. You're a terrific showman, I mean it. They really lay on terrific. Boy, you're terrific. You can show the best of them, boy. You're really, you're terrific. Okay. What else do I want to show? I have some other goodies.